Kidlets, or the, you know, not so little Kidlets. Back in the 90s, our next guest was part of the indie rock scene in Montreal when she went by the name Cecil C. Skull. In fact, this is where Cecil and I first met back in the day. Since then, now Cecil Castellucci, maybe sometimes Cecil C. Skull, has used the written word to express her creativity, authoring several books for young people ranging from toddlers to young adults. I am a fan for many reasons, and I'm so happy you're here.
I know, I'm happy to see you too.
Like two decades later.
I know. Good morning.
Good morning. So now you're living in LA.
Yep.
So talk about the transition going from indie rocker, but you went to film school.
Yep.
So obviously you're a creative person, but then you jumped right into writing books.
Yeah. I've always felt, you know how like artists, like painters, they can like they can do a sketch in pencil or charcoal or watercolor or whatever. I felt like it's kind of the same thing with storytelling. And so I feel like for me it's just telling a story in a different way. So doing bands and writing lyrics to writing novels or whatever else I write, you know, it's all sort of the same thing, but just sort of using a different pencil. So that transition wasn't hard. It was harder sort of just being like, okay, now I'm putting this career away and I'm going to start this career.
And then talk about getting published, because I mean, it's any author will tell you it's not so easy just to do that.
It's not so easy. It's not like I wrote a book, sent it out, and then they were like, of course. You know, I wrote 3 young adult novels before I sold my 4th one. And so my 4th book written was my first book published. And then those 3, they will never see the light of day. But the nice thing is that you know, every book that I got rejected from, I got encouragement, you know, like, you should keep doing this. This doesn't suck too badly. Like, you know, keep going. So, yeah, so it was a process.
Well, imagine how many, I mean, a songwriter, for instance, how many songs they have in their back pocket
that
will also never see the light of day. Talk about the audience, though. That's that's really interesting to me. How did you find the young adult audience and go younger also?
I think that if we asked everybody in this room or everybody watching, you know, what their favorite book was from their childhood, they all have one right in their head right away. And I feel like young adult youth is when we fall in love with reading and when we fall in love with stories. And also as a writer, most of my books are young adults, so 12 and up. It's the moment where you sort of decide what kind of a human being you're going to be, if you're going to be good, if you're going to be bad, if you're going to be, you know, I don't know, whatever, how you're going to vote, all of that stuff. And everything is the first time, first love, first betrayal, first rage, first everything. So as a writer, that's a very ripe, interesting time to write about.
Now, we don't have time to get to too much. This is one of the young adult. This is part graphic novel, part novel. But I want to spend more time just quickly talking about this other one that I have here. This is for younger audience, well, I guess readers, except for the fact that there's a bunch of stuff in there for grown-ups, too, which is amazing. This is called Odd Duck. And then now let's talk about Tin Star. Mm-hmm. What is that?
Tin Star, it comes out in February, and it's my, usually I write contemporary about young artsy girls. And this is, Tin Star is my first science fiction book, so it's about a girl, a human girl who's abandoned on an alien space station at the brink of a galactic war. And it's book one of a 2-book series.
And this is such a ripe time also, I think, for young adult literature.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, because everybody can read it.
Yeah.
Adults feel fine reading it
as well. It's even, I mean, that's the great thing about young adult books is that they're actually just books. You can just read them because they're actually great books. And I think some of the best science fiction and fantasy is happening in young adult fiction right now.
I am so excited that you're here. Thank you so much for joining us today. It's MissCecil.com if you want to see all the incredible variety of things that Cecil is doing. Information and links, breakfasttelevision.ca.